Today, I'm going to mention some tips and tricks for transfer learning I experienced in this webinar. Let me introduce myself first. This is Shefik, and I have been working as a software developer for a fintech company since 2010, and I received my master's degree in computer science in 2011. And I have a personal blog, shefik.com. You can find all information about me here. And finally, you can contact me on Twitter with my surname. Andrew Ng is one of the pioneers of applied machine learning, and he is a professor at Stanford University Computer Science Department. Also, he is the founder of the Coursera. He believes that transfer learning will be the next driver of the machine learning success. So, what's transfer learning? It's like a mentorship program of AI, and you can have outcomes of successful ones. Besides, you might bypass the learning steps. Consider ImageNet challenge in Kaggle. There are millions of images consisting of thousands of categories, and you are expected to build a model to classify any image based on these existing categories. These are popular winner models, and size of the circle states the complexity of the model, whereas location of the y-axis represents the accuracy. Let's focus on the VGG model. Creators of the VGG model describe the model in this original paper, Deep Face Recognition. And we can see the details of each layer in this table. For example, it says that you should apply 64 filters sized 3x3 matrix in first layer. So we can design the Keras model based on the table mentioned in the previous slide. It's very easy actually. Also, we have already known that this model is good at classify images, also face recognition. But the raw model needs to be trained. And we can apply training by calling the fit command as illustrated here. Or popular models exist in Keras. We can just import the related model as shown here. Remember that almost hundreds of engineers work on these models to design. Also, they have powerful hardware, hundreds of CPU cores, multiple GPUs or tensor processing units. They all cost $10,000 nowadays, and they spent weeks or months to train the model, and most significantly they have a really big data. So it's clear that just having the network structure is not enough. Please consider the Inov Kunkwi scene in the matrix, and Neo is connected to computer, and then he suddenly learns the kung fu. He even didn't do training. We can bypass the training and use the same pre-trained weights in reference study. For example, you can find the weights of the VGG face model here. So we can apply same predictions with the model owners just in seconds. For instance, here I used the Inception version 3 model and its pre-trained weights to classify images, and the model says that this image is 76% Eskimo dog or 19% husky. Using same pre-trained weights is pretty, and we often do it, but we cannot customize the problem in this way. I mean that there are thousands of output labels in the Inception model, but what if I just want to classify an image cat or dog? Can I customize the Inception for this problem? The answer is yes, but you must apply training. Remember that Neo needs to train after Kung Fu is loaded to him. This is the network structure of the Inception version 3 model, and early layers detect edges and shapes of the images. This might be helpful for my custom problem. On the other hand, final layers serve for classification. Here I can lock or freeze the earning layers and customize the final layers based on my problem. But in this case, I need to retrain the model. Here I load the weights of VGG model first, then lock the weights of all layers except the final 7 one. And add 101 labels on the output layer. Remember that a regular VGG model has 1000 labels, but this is for edge classification problem, and I need to predict edges between 0 and 101. That's why I customize the problem in this way. And finally, I apply training. To sum up, you can apply full training in transfer learning, but this is not a common usage. You should have millions of training data and powerful hardware. Secondly, skipping training is an alternative. In this case, you should use pre-trained weights of a popular model, but you cannot customize the problem in this case. On the other hand, just having the test data is enough, and you don't have to have a powerful hardware. And finally, you can apply partial training and partial learning. You should lock and freeze early layers and customize the output layer of the model based on your problem. This is required. In this case, you should have thousands of training data, and this is acceptable. So I have mentioned some experiences I have about transfer learning in this webinar. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.